Okay, here we are with the next part of this car. So, I have these seats here that I was working on. So I was gonna be working on this part right here. Okay, so now I'm gonna be making, I guess, this inner piece. These will connect to this. And of course, I still have my reference images. Okay, let's see. First. Save those parts for last. So what I'm gonna try to do now is create this inner plane for the car. Just going back to my side view. That should be the plane that I just created. Oh, centering it out and I'm scaling it. I'm trying to match. This is basically gonna be the entire floor plane. For the car. Back to my reference images. You can see, like, this whole part pretty much stretches along the inside until center console area. Like, you see, it rests upon the floor, so What I'm gonna do is hold this in. And I'm going to extrude it. Accidentally press the wrong button. That happens sometimes. And I'm gonna extrude it again. But this time I'm gonna just bring it over. And of course, I can center it, pivot. So that way, if I duplicate special it, you know, I have like the center aisle, and I have this part of the carpet where the consoles in the middle and everything rests upon. So let me undo that. Just seat over a bit. So it's going to be a smooth area. You can see everything is pretty smooth, so I'm going to bevel that. Whoa. Of course my settings are always too high. Okay, I'm not gonna spend all day on that. basically I'm gonna merge these two these parts together. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. So across this area will be the footrest, you know, where you rest the pedals. So if you're wondering, basically down here is where I'm, is what I'm creating. So this nice area that connects into this, because then I'm going to put the console, you know, it connects to right here, and then of course this whole console set, then this whole dashboard will go in. So yeah, with each thing that I do, of course, you know, I think about every area, every aspect of the car that I'm creating. So yeah, this part's gonna have to connect. With the edges of the door, so I turn on the front door, back door, yeah. also do it with just a fight it a couple of times. So it's a pretty thick area. I'm just gonna undo some of the movements I did. And try to keep it close to seats, because it's kind of hard to tell, but you can see it's pretty close, because yeah, you got the part that's right there for the safety seat belts. So I don't really need to bring all that. go on a curve a bit. So this part that I'm extruding, it's basically, you know, this edge, this thickness that comes out and wraps around the doors. So if I bring back the front door, I mean, it's thick, but it's not that thick. Front door. I think I need to make the door a bit thicker. It's supposed to should come in a little more to match up with that piece. So I'm just gonna scale this in a bit more. Yeah, that. Just looking a bit right. And of course, you have to have it curved at the bottom. And that's when this part comes in. Those two. Just bring this part up. Yeah, definitely want to fix this part a bit. We'll have to readjust the front doors. Chairs back. Chairs look like they're in the right spot. I'm gonna go off of this image and use this as the guideline for this part. And just bring it over. Definitely, I have to work out some of this. So it like lines up and matches. Because right now, I'm not sure if I should move the seat over a bit, or bring the door in a bit. I think I could start with just the faces of this back door. Okay, so yeah, definitely. This part's a bit too close. If I bevel that part, weird. This side first before I do that. Okay, not bad. It's a bit weird, but not bad at all. Let's see if I throw this into the mix. Okay. So yeah, that's even better. Oh. Yeah, I could work with this. that hatch, that hatch. Oh, yeah, what? I'll need to create a crease there. That's more like what I'm trying to do. Just that's more like it. So then I could do the same on this side. Yeah, it's all about figuring out how you want to go about doing certain things. So for this part, oops. So as you can see, it comes around and wraps up here. So I'm going to do the same. Okay. So I need to wrap up and come around here. And then come across. Gonna come across center here and kind of form like that back part of the back seat. So this is like a slow build for the interior. Definitely gotta work some parts out so that they match up, so that it's sealed perfectly, so that the door Also seals. So like parts like this. Definitely. Now if I bevel it to right there, would change the way the door is on the outside. So let's see if I could do a bevel in just before there and turn that down a bit. And yeah, that might actually work towards. So yeah, just shaping it up. So definitely we're working inside of this door. As well as this inner piece that we're making, so that way you have a nice sleek doorway. And of course I'm gonna have it match up so that it comes over and covers like these gaps in between. So once I do that part up here at the top, yeah, I'm definitely gonna have it match up over here on the top part. So basically, brought this part over. So these two vertex get to merge. So this is one part that's pretty much complete. It's just a matter of matching it up a bit. The best way to do that is through the vertex. So holding the V key, I'm just gonna snap it accordingly. So to make things easier, I'll turn on wireframe shading so I can see some points that I can snap it to. Thank you. So I'll just add some more points right here. Just to help with it. So as we can see, all seats, the inside is coming along. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna screw it out some more here to try to fill in for the space for like where the car door locks and seals, and like, you know, these outer edges to seal in the car. So when you open the door, you don't see a hole in the mesh. If you turn off the door, clear its history, freeze its transformations, and just duplicate special. Although, for this final piece, I'm not gonna duplicate it, just like with the outside of the car, gonna, merge it. But you can see, starts to look nice if you smooth preview it. Kind of like how the seats are in smooth preview, because then it'll subdivide it a whole lot, but you'll have like this inside of the car, looking how it's supposed to. And like if I turn on a door, it starts to give you that look and feel of a car. So I'm gonna stop this part here. This section of the video is pretty much gonna be it. Definitely on the next part, we'll be continuing with the back here. I'm going to, create this whole back part of the back seats. And then that'll be attached to this main area. And then from there, I'll create the roof, the ceiling, I should say, the inside ceiling of the car, and connect. Probably either connect it or have it touching near these parts, to give like the crease here. And of course, you have a crease here, and the same with the front. And of course, I noticed this one. I mean, this car, obviously, you notice there's 1, 2, 3 seats, so this is like a 4-seat car. So it's not entirely the same as this, which is what the outside actually looks like for what I'm working on. But, like I said, this is kind of like my original version of the car. I'm just taking designs and that I like and putting it together. And of course, if anything, I could still just make one big backseat. This part can be interchangeable. I can always just take this section I have here and just lower it down a bit. Like in some cars, of course I bring this part up here in the middle, but some cars in the back, they still have like that part that comes up even when you're in the full back seat. So it's like I could just make one big back seat. I could just like make one giant back seat. Like, obviously I wouldn't do it like this, but this is just for an example. Like, I could just put like one big back seat and just have that lower part. Of course, if I really were to do it, like, I would probably duplicate this over like right here and create another piece in between to connect them. So let me undo. Okay. Definitely want to freeze the transformations though on that. And as always, ending your videos and, or if you're working with it, click save. You want to make sure your work is saved. Even though you have the autosave, with the way I have the current autosave, it does take up a lot of memory. And I end up finding myself going back and deleting a lot of those save files, because they do take up space. But, saving is important. So, taking it one step at a time, working on each part of this interior. So we did the seats in the last video, worked on this little side window for here on the car. We worked outside so that we can have a window there, and as you can see, we go into the interior, and then we end up having that area so that now we can work with it and create it. So now, look forward to the next part of this video. So this car is definitely coming along. Will almost be like 100% in half, except for the dashboard. The dashboard is going to be one big thing across, because steering wheel is obviously not on both sides, but everything else pretty much can be mirrored over. So see you in the next part.